left scenes that I cannot see. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We're the grateful heart. We're the song of praise. We're the outstretched arm. I will bless your name.
Let's begin to worship the name of the Lord this morning. Let's begin to bless his name, for he is our God. He's good and his mercies endure forever. With a grateful heart this morning, let's begin to praise his holy name. Bless his name. Begin to call him those beautiful names. Tell him how much you appreciate him this morning. Daddy, we adore your name. The Prince of Peace, the Rose of Sharon, the Everlasting Father. We worship your holy name. We worship your majesty. We just want to say you are the Lord. We want to say there's none like you. You're the omnipotent God. You are the Lion of the tribe of Judah. You are the Ancient of Days. You are the I am that I am. You are the one yesterday, today, and forevermore. You reign forever. Daddy, we worship your majesty. As a family, we come before you this morning and say, you are the Lord. We declare that you are the Lord over our lives. We declare you are the Lord over everything that belongs to us. We worship your mighty name this morning. We're not keeping quiet. We're not keeping quiet. We just want to let you know how much we appreciate you. Oh, you're higher than the highest. You're the almighty God. You're the joy unspeakable. Daddy, we bless your holy name. Oh, let my soul begin to bless your holy name this morning. Oh, Daddy, I want to say thank you for everything. Thank you for your love. Thank you for your hands of favor. Thank you for strength. You've called us to dedicate the first 7 day of the month to you. Daddy, we thank you because you saw us through. We thank you for answered prayers. We thank you for provisions. We thank you for fighting every battle for us. Thank you, Master Jesus. Thank you for the grace of a new day. For we slept like a log of wood without knowing what was happening around us. But you stood for us. You fought for us until we woke up this morning. We just want to say thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Abba Father, for in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Good morning, everyone. Thank you so much for tuning in today. Amen. Today is the last day of this prayer and fasting, and we just want to rejoice for every good thing the Lord has done. Maybe you haven't seen it yet, but I know it was something to manifest in the name of Jesus. That moment we started to pray is the moment God started to walk behind the scene for your favor. I declare this morning that every good thing the Lord has done will be permanent in the name of Jesus. The one who has started a good thing in your life will bring it into completion in the name of Jesus. All you will see right now is the hand of God over everything that concerns you in the name of Jesus. No more limitation. You will never be stopped in the name of Jesus. The Lord will take you to where it's designed for you to be in the name of Jesus. Amen. This morning we want to talk about progress in Thanksgiving. Hallelujah. Do you know the Lord wants you to progress in your Thanksgiving? Maybe you haven't even been thanking God because you're thinking there's nothing new in my life. Oh, that blessing is already still. It's been there for so long. I don't need to give him glory anymore. The Lord wants you and I to progress in the way we thank him. He wants us to thank him more. Hallelujah. 1 Chronicles 16 verse 34 says, oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he's good. His steadfast love endures forever. God doesn't just love you today and stop loving you tomorrow. His love endureth forever. So we, every time, every moment, we're meant to give him glory. We're meant to give him thanks. God wants us us to progress in our thanksgiving. And as we do so, blessings will begin to fall into our lives in the name of Jesus. You know, I love God so much. It's not a God that pushes us so much, especially when we keep quiet, when we don't really appreciate his works in our lives. You can say to me at that side, no, God hasn't been answering my prayers. I don't have any reason to thank him. I want to say that you are here today, that your life today is by the grace of God. It deserves your thanksgiving. It deserves you to say, thank you, Jesus. Just look up and say, thank you, Jesus. God wants us to progress in thanksgiving. I'm going to share with you some disciplines and habits to develop or to enable us to grow in the way we thank God. You know, giving thanks require practice. You don't just do it today and not do it tomorrow. We've got to do thank God continually. Let it come from your heart, not just from your mouth. You've got to, you know, even when whether or not things are going well, you just give him thanks. Father, I thank you for this situation. The scripture says in every circumstances, we should give glory to God. So we have got to develop this habit that in all things, we give him thanks regularly. Even on, you know, on those outdated blessings, we still give him thanks. What is done for you from the beginning of your life, you just say, Father, I thank you. I thank you. It's by your grace I'm still here. I thank you for every battle. We've got every reason to give him thanks. So please don't be quiet. We've got to give him thanks in every area of our lives. Amen. You know, give thanks in all circumstances. I don't know what you're going through this morning, and the devil doesn't actually want you to, you know, to show your act of gratitude to him. I'm saying to you, in every circumstances, this is what the Paul said to the Thessalonians. He said, give thanks in all circumstances, for it is the will of God. And if we as Christians want to do the will of God, I'm saying to us this morning, it is the will of God for us to give him thanks. Whether or not things are going well, just say, thank you, Jesus. The scripture says he knows the ending from the beginning. He's a loving God. He's a caring God. He wouldn't allow evil to happen if there wasn't a purpose for it. So in every situation of our lives, let's give him thanks, for it is the will of God. You know, thank God when things are going well. You know, many of us, when things are going on smoothly, we tend to forget God. We tend to leave God out of it. We think, oh, it's just by our own power, because things are just working out smoothly for us, and we take God out of the picture. So I want us to thank God, even thank him more and more when things are going on smoothly. This is not a time to just enjoy life without God. This is a time to do it with God. Every moment, and you appreciate everything the Lord is doing. So I want you to, you know, make an habit from this and say, I'm just going to thank God no matter what I go through. Now that things are going well, I'm going to thank God. If things go otherwise, I'm going to thank God. And you will see God blessing you more and more, because it says, when, you know, there's a saying that when praises goes up, blessings comes down. God wants to bless you. He wants to enlarge your course. He wants to anoint you, but he needs your thanksgiving. Hallelujah. I want you to also recognize the good things the Lord has done, or the good experience you've gained, even in your tribulations. You know, in our lives, we've got to take this time out and just reflect on the victory God has given unto us. You know, that moment you were just fighting, you were in that battle, and you just saw God fought the battle for us. We've got to take our time and reflect on it and say, thank you, Jesus. There's so many people who don't actually receive victory, but ours, victory is ours. In every circumstance, victory is ours. We've got to reflect on this and give him all the glory. We've got every reason to thank God, no matter how bad the situation is. We've got every reason to thank God. I want us to understand that fact, that we were created to thank him. We weren't created to just do our lives without him. We were created for him. That was why he created you and I in his own image. He needs to hear our voice. Heaven needs to hear our voices. This morning, we're going to say thank you. And I want you to make it an habit to say thank you, Jesus, in every situation. Every morning you wake up, every time you just say thank you, Jesus. Don't let this devil stop you from thanking him. Don't ever let the devil stop you from thanking him. It is the will of God, and we've got to obey him. We've got to do his will in the name of Jesus. I want you to understand the power of giving thanks. Thanksgiving is so powerful. It's super powerful. It is important for children of God to, you know, to thank God. It is powerful when God just looked at you and see your heart of gratitude to him. It makes him really happy. It makes him want to do more for us. Not that, oh my God, you question God all the time. It's not a thing of God. We Christians must not practice in that. Just questioning God, asking God why. All we've got to do is just thank God. Thank God. Thank him, not from your mouth, but from your heart, and you will see his blessings upon you in the name of Jesus. Every morning, every night, every moment, just look around and say, Father, I thank you that I'm still here. I'm here because you actually want me to thank you. Thank you, Jesus. So this morning, we're going to thank God for everything. In everything, we're going to say, thank you, Jesus. Begin to open your mouth and say, Father, I thank you for strength. I thank you for power. I tell you, it's not so easy to wake up early in the morning to pray to God, but God has made it easy for us. There's some people that they don't even have it in their hearts to pray to God. They're just doing their lives without God, not forgetting that God created them. But this is not our portion. We recognize that we are the children of God. It's worth thanking God for. Daddy, I thank you for knowing you. I thank you this morning for being your follower. Thank God for power. Thank God for the anointing is giving you. Thank God for his mercies. Daddy, we worship your name. We thank you for every answered prayers. We thank you for everything you've done, even during the course of this prayer and fasting. We just want to appreciate you this morning. Thank you, glorious Father, for in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Amen. Psalm 9 verse 1 says, I will give thanks to you, Lord, with all my heart. I will tell of your wonderful deeds. Hallelujah. You know, it's one thing to give glory to God. It's one thing to share your testimony. God allowed or he permitted you to go through that experience, and he gave you the victory because he wants you to share with others. He wants you to strengthen someone else. He wants someone to hear about his good news. So we're going to say, Father, I thank you. I just want to thank you because you are my Lord. I want to thank you because you are my Father. I want to thank you for every work you continually to do in my life. In the name of Jesus. Thank God this morning. Don't keep quiet. Oh, my soto basha da da da. I want to thank you for everything you're doing in my life. In the name of Jesus. I want to thank you for your work in my life. I just want to celebrate you this morning. I want to say you are my number one. I'm thanking you for my heart this morning. Thank you for your favor. Thank you for power. Thank you for anointing. Thank you for strength. Thank you for every good thing you've given unto me. Thank you for this ministry. Thank you for how you started with us. Thank you for where we are now. I want to thank you for where you're taking us to. Daddy, I thank you on the behalf of your people this morning. Thank you for the strength given unto them to wait upon your name. In the name of Jesus, we adore your name. For in Jesus' mighty name, we have praise. Amen. It says, I will tell of your wondrous deed. Why not begin to tell him this morning? Begin to share with him. Say, you know, just think about every good thing the Lord has done in your life and begin to thank him for it this morning. Daddy, I thank you for the grace given unto me to see 2019. I thank you for preserving my life in the name of Jesus. I thank you because you're always walking in my life. You've never gone on vacation on my behalf. Daddy, I just want to celebrate you. I thank you for every battle you fought for me. Thank you for the prayers that you've answered. Thank you for every prayer I've rendered unto you during the course of this 7-day prayer and fasting. And I thank you because you've done it in the name of Jesus. Thank you, glorious Father, for in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Psalm 107 verse 8 to 9 says, let them give thanks to the Lord for his unfailing love and wondrous deeds to mankind. We're going to take it one after the other. Do you believe God loves you so much? You are the number one person in the heart of God. They said, I tattooed your name on my palm. He thinks about you. He loves you so much. I just want you to take time out this morning and say, Father, I thank you for your unfailing love. I thank, even when I make mistakes in my life, you never stop loving me. You never stop showing me your kindness. You never stop giving me your care. I thank you for your unfailing love, for loving me. No one can love me the way you do. No one can care for me the way you do. No one can be so kind to me the way you do. Father, I thank you for your unfailing love over my life, over my family, over this ministry, Daddy. We thank you because all we can see is your love. In the name of Jesus, Daddy, we worship your name. We thank you so much for your unfailing love. We thank you because your love is all we need and you give it to us. You never starve us of your love. Daddy, we just want to say thank you, Jesus. Thank you for loving it a lady like me. Thank you for loving with all my shortcomings. Thank you for loving me. I appreciate your holy name. For in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. It's a and his wondrous deed to mankind. You want to agree with me today that God has been faithful. God has been so loving. He does good things for us and he will never stop. Let's thank him. Thank him this morning. Daddy, I thank you for your faithfulness over my life. I thank you for your faithfulness over our lives. We just want to say thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for strength. Thank you for power. Thank you for anointing. Thank you for fighting every battle. Thank you for your wondrous deed to mankind. Thank you for your favor upon mankind. In the name of Jesus, even when all hopes is lost, you come with your power. You come with your favor. We're not keeping quiet. We're just saying thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. For in Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. It says, for he satisfies the thirsty and fills the hungry with good things. Hallelujah. Can you remember when you were hungry? I'm not talking about hunger for food right now. When you were hungry, you know, for care, for protection, when you just needed someone to be by your side and God was there. Why not thank him for it this morning? Daddy, I thank you for, you know, for satisfying my thirst in the name of Jesus. I thank you for filling my hungry in the name of Jesus, filling me with your words to speak, filling me with your comfort. Daddy, we just want to say thank you, Jesus, because you are a God who satisfies the thirsty. In the name of Jesus, you are a God who fills the hungry with good thing. Daddy, I just want to thank you this morning for every good thing you've deposited in my life, for every good thing you've deposited in my family, in this ministry, in the name of Jesus, because you are not a God that leaves us or forsakes us. Daddy, we just want to say thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Master King, for you are a God who satisfies the thirsty. You are a God who fills the hungry. Daddy, we just want to say thank you, Jesus. We're not taking every good thing you're doing for granted. We thank you because our lives is filled with good things from you, blessings from you, favor from you, overflow from you in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Master Jesus, for in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Philippians 4 verse 6 to 7 says, do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your request to God. I don't know what you've been praying for from the first day of this prayer and fasting. The Lord is saying, don't be anxious about anything. I am on the throne. I'm more than able to turn every situation around. He said, but in every situation, by prayer and petition with thanksgiving, present your request to God. This morning, I want you to present your request to God. Maybe we haven't been able to mention your cases. I just want you to present your request to God. Where you are this morning, don't be anxious. Just relax and begin to present your request to him. Talk to God this morning. Let it be between you and God. Oh, Masoto Bashadadadada. Daddy, you made me to know that worry won't help me. Being anxious won't help me. You've told me to present my case to you in prayer, in petition, and in thanksgiving. I want to thank you for everything is turning around for my favor in the name of Jesus. I want to thank you for I believe that this is my season of rapid progress in the name of Jesus. This month, February 2019, I will progress in every area of my life in the name of Jesus. Daddy, I just want to thank you for every good works you're doing in my life. In the name of Jesus, I thank you because there's no situation in my life that is too big for you to handle. I thank you because you are a God who uproots every disappointment, who uproots every delay in the name of Jesus. I want to celebrate you right now because of everything you've done, and so shall it be in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. It says, and the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, we guard your heart and your mind in Jesus' name. Amen. I just want you to pray that I envelope myself with the peace of God all through the month of February, all through this year 2019. The peace of God is with me. The peace that surpasses every understanding is with me. In the name of Jesus, I function in the peace of God. Why not talk to God this morning? Oh, Masoto Basha, da 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 da. Daddy, I thank you because this is my season of peace. In the name of Jesus, I leave myself to dwell in your peace right now. Thank you, Master Jesus, for in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this hour. We thank you for every time we spent in your prayer from 1st of February to 7th to today. We thank you for the time we still spend in your presence all through this month. We thank you for every good thing you're doing right now. We thank you for every limitation that has been taken off. We thank you for every barrier that has been broken. We thank you for every gate that you've opened for us. We thank you for, we know that we're progressing on every side. Daddy, we want to thank you because we've called upon you as instructed and you've answered our prayers. Daddy, we pray that every good thing you've done will begin to manifest in the name of Jesus. Daddy, I want to thank you on behalf of your children. I thank you for the power you've given to them, for faith you've given to them, for the power for them to believe again, to turn to you to pray. Daddy, I pray their lives will be reflection of your favor, reflection of your breakthrough in the name of Jesus. This month, oh Lord, they progress rapidly in every area of their lives in the name of Jesus. They will not be stopped, they will not be limited in the name of Jesus. Daddy, I declare over their lives right now, they go to enjoy life, they go to enjoy every blessing you've released unto them, they go to enjoy every favor, and so shall it be in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. I want to congratulate you all, you know, for creating time to pray to God, and you will see, you'll begin to, you know, to reap what you've sown even at this period in the name of Jesus. God is doing good things for you, and I want you to believe it so strongly in the name of Jesus. Never stop praying all through today. I want you to do is just to thank God. Present your cases to him in thanksgiving, and our lives will never remain the same in the name of Jesus. God bless you. I want to invite you to our forthcoming programs. On Sunday, we have a biblical teaching by 8 a.m. GMT. Please, great time to join us. It's an hour teaching. You know, the Lord wants us to know more of him. So please don't hesitate to join us. And there's something big coming for the youths in this ministry. Hallelujah. The Lord wants to talk to you. He's preparing his servant, Pastor Wale, to join you on 16th by 8 p.m. GMT. He's going to be talking to you about you are pencils in the hands of the maker. We are all youth anyway, no matter how old we think we are, we are youth, and the Lord wants to talk to us. He wants to empower us. He wants to elevate us. So please create time to join us on 16th of this month. Further information will be posted on our pages. God bless you and enjoy your day in Jesus' name. Amen.